President Trump slams ungrateful UCLA player's father with epic new nickname. Crooked Hillary. Little Marco. Lion Ted. And now, the poor man's Don King. Yes, that last one is the latest in a line of nicknames bequeathed by President Trump on those who earned them. Find them childish, find them hilarious, find them both, you can't help but be engaged by them. And, if you're on the receiving end, you probably can't help but be enraged by them. The latest recipient of a Trump-branded moniker is LaVar Ball, the father of Los Angeles Lakers rookie Lonzo Ball and UCLA freshman basketball player LiAngelo Ball. As you may have heard, LiAngelo got himself into a little jam abroad when he and three others shoplifted some expensive sunglasses from a Louis Vuitton store next to the team's hotel in China, which team officials said was among three stores they shoplifted from. As China is not known for its lenience toward these sorts of things, the Chicago Tribune reports that the young men were possibly looking at 1 to 2 years in a prison system that makes hours look like Holiday Inn. The Trump administration lobbied the Chinese for their release, with the president saying he personally interceded with Chinese President Xi Jinping. Once they were back on American soil, LiAngelo and his teammates thanked Trump, but LaVar went out of his way to disparage the president's role in the matter. This led to a much-debated tweet in which the president said he should have left them in jail. There had been some silence on the great LaVar Ball, Donald Trump debate, and one might have thought that their war of words had died down. Alas, no. Ball went on CNN and again questioned whether the president had anything to do with his son's release. How'd he help? If he helped, I would say thank you, the ungrateful Ball said during a wonderfully unhinged interview with CNN's Chris Cuomo. In case you missed the elevated discourse on the most trusted name in news on Monday night, here's some highlights assembled by a YouTube user. The interview was so ridiculous that the Washington Post actually started their story on it by calling LaVar Ball a one-man blaring megaphone who has become the loudest voice on the NBA sidelines because of constant carnival barking about his son's and the family's big baller brand. Sounds about right. And if the WAPO is willing to do that, just imagine where the president is willing to go. The good news is, it takes no imagination. Since he decided to let us in on his thoughts and re-LaVar Ball through his favorite medium. The 5 to 10 potential sentence is a bit of an exaggeration, but poor man's Don King is pretty much spot on. It's worth noting that King was a Trump supporter, so it's probably good he clarified with the poor man's part. You don't want to lose the Don King vote. If you're one of those nattering nabobs of negative feedback when it comes to Trump's social media accounts and whether or not they're presidential, I have just one question: is the characterization accurate? I'm not going to show you the full 23 minutes of LaVar Ball's interview with Chris Cuomo because, well, I don't hate our readers that much. What one can glean from the highlights is that A, he is inadvertently funny in small doses and B, this is a loudmouth who rarely even commutes to reality, much less lives in it. As much as he may want to be a sports impresario, the fact remains that he's little more than a minor celebrity, something like the situation from Jersey Shore, only somehow more irritating. The poor man's Don King? That's almost too kind for him. But it's still funny.